Hello friends, a warm welcome to our next session on instrumentation and control in power plant industry. In our previous session, we have discussed about the various types of temperature measuring devices used in a power plant. In a power plant for temperature measurement, we use thermocouples, RTDs, infrared thermometers, biometallic temperature gauges, gas thermometers, thermistors, fiber optic temperature gauges, then thermal imaging cameras, and mercury in glass. In this session, we will discuss about thermocouple in detail. In upcoming slides, we will learn what is a thermocouple, on which principle it works, the thermowells for installing thermocouples in the process pipelines, basically they work as their protective covering, then what are the different types of thermocouples, what are the applications, and the advantages and limitations of thermocouples. So our basic question in mind is, what is a thermocouple? Friends, thermocouple is a temperature measuring device. The word thermocouple is made up of two words, thermo plus couple. As per Oxford dictionary, the word thermo is something related to heat, and the word couple we know is a pair or connected together, means it has a pair or couple of two dissimilar metals joined together to make a junction. This junction is heated by the process fluid. In this figure, we can see two wires are shown. One is blue colored wire, that is wire A, and second is red colored wire B. Both these wires are of dissimilar metals. These wires are connected at one end forming a junction. This junction is inserted into the hot process fluid. Here in this figure, the temperature source is shown as a candle. So this junction is inserted into the hot process fluid, and thus this junction is called hot junction, while the other end of these metallic wires is called the cold junction or reference junction and is connected to a voltmeter in series. Due to this temperature difference, the hot junction between the hot junction and the cold junction, a thermocouple produces an electrical voltage, very small voltage, basically called Seebeck voltage. It is in millivolts, generally ranging from 25 up to 30 millivolt. This voltage can be interpreted to measure temperature. Clear? Thermocouples have positive temperature coefficient. That means as the temperature of the hot junction increases with respect to the reference junction temperature, the millivolt generated will also increase, whereas the millivolt generated will decrease as the hot junction temperature decreases. Clear? Thermocouples are positive temperature coefficients. Then coming to its principle, it works on the principle of Seebeck effect. In year 1821, the German physicist Thomas John Seebeck observed that if two dissimilar metals are joined together to make a closed circuit and one junction is kept at different temperature than the other, then an electromotive force is generated. This causes an electric current to flow in the closed circuit, and the amount of current flowing in the circuit is proportional to the temperature difference between the two junctions. So if one junction, that is the cold junction, is kept at a fixed temperature, that is reference temperature value, then by measuring the voltage generated in the circuit, the other end, that is the hot end temperature, can be determined. For our purpose, we can say this generation of voltage due to temperature difference between the two junctions made up of two dissimilar metals is called Seebeck effect. If you talk about its history, basically T.J. Seebeck first discovered that a magnetic needle was getting deflected when he placed it near a closed circuit made up of two dissimilar metals and one of their junction was heated. He named it as a thermomagnetism. Later on, it was discovered that this deflection was due to thermoelectric current. And for our measurement purpose, instead of using this current, we measure the induced EMF, that is the voltage across the circuit. This DC voltage is very small, up to 25 to 30 millivolt range. These millivolts are then calibrated into corresponding temperature reading. Please remember, this is the temperature difference. Basically, this voltage is corresponding to the temperature difference. So we need to compensate the cold and temperature from the measurement. Clear? In this way, we get the process fluid temperature in which the hot temperature end is inserted. Now, in order to protect our thermocouple, this hot junction, which I just said it is in contact with the process fluid, is actually not in direct contact with the process fluid. Rather, we use thermowells, which are inserted in the pipeline. Typically, these thermowells are inserted up to middle of the pipe, that is half of the pipe diameter. These thermowells are hollow and act as a protective covering for our thermocouples. And the heat from process is transferred to these thermowells, and through conduction, it is transferred to our thermocouple. They are not only protecting our thermocouple, but for maintenance purpose also, it is easy to remove our thermocouple and recalibrate it after a certain time of operation. Basically, these thermowells are of three types. Either they have threaded connection, flanged, or welded. Next question in mind is, why this voltage is generated in this circuit? Friends, you must have observed, when one end of a metal is heated, then after some time the other end is also getting hot. Why this happens? Basically, due to heating, the electrons in the metal get energized and they start moving to the colder end to reach a more stable position. Here we have already mentioned multiple times that the two metals are dissimilar. So on heating, their electrons move at different speed towards the cold junction. At the cold junction, these electrons start gathering. One of the metal with higher electron speed gets more electrons at its cold end, while the other metal with slower electron speed get comparatively less electrons gathered at this cold junction. Electrons, we know, are negatively charged particles. So the metals where more electrons are piled up is more negatively charged as compared to the other metals end. Clear? Like in this figure, the flow of electrons in alumel is faster than chromal. Thus, at cold junction, we can see more electrons are gathered at alumel as compared to chromal. Thus, alumel is more negatively charged as compared to chromal. That is, alumel end has negative potential as compared to chromal, and chromal end has positive potential as compared to alumel. This potential difference is measured through voltmeter and is calibrated to give hot and temperature reading. Clear? Next, coming to its types, as per NC, the American National Standard Institute, and ASTM, there are 9 main thermocouples types. Basically, type B, type E, J, K, N, R, S, T, and C. The most common used in power plant industry is type K, which is chromal alumel, with the alumel containing 5% nickel. It is durable and has a wide temperature range ranging from minus 200 degrees centigrade to plus 1250 degrees centigrade. We can easily identify the type of thermocouple from its color coding. For type K, the color coding is yellow and red. Rest all thermocouples I have listed in this table, along with their material of construction, their color coding, and the temperature range they can operate. Now, coming to the thermocouple applications, basically thermocouples are almost in each and every industry and have a very wide application area. Thermocouples are used in applications that range from home appliances to industrial processes, to electrical power generation, to furnace monitoring and control, in food and beverage processing, automotive sensors, aircraft engines, rockets, satellites, and spacecraft. when it comes to high temperatures, small size, fast response, high vibration or shock, most times you will find thermocouples providing the temperature measurement. In food and food applications, thermocouples can be used in wide variety of applications, like in clean in place sensors, penetration probes, oven control, food chain monitoring, hot plate control and monitoring, even in steam kettle temperature control. Our type T thermocouple are ideal for inert atmosphere and are resistant to decomposition. So type T thermocouples are used in food production and cryogenic. In this photograph, you can see a handheld thermocouple used in food applications. Then thermocouples are used for extruders. Extruders require high temperature and pressure, and generally type K is used in extruders. Then for low temperature measurement, our type E, type K, type T and type N thermocouples can be used for measuring temperatures down to minus 200 degrees centigrade. Even in furnace control, our type C are used because type C have a very high temperature range up to plus 2315 degrees centigrade. In molten metals, our type K and type N base metals and type R, S and B platinum thermocouples are the choices for contact measurement in this area. In petrochemical industry, the type N thermocouples have exceptional resistance to rot and hysteresis and are used in refineries and petrochemical industries. Then coming to the advantages and disadvantages, they have various advantages like high accuracy, they are robust and can be used in harsh environment. They have fast thermal reaction, that is thermocouples have a very fast response time. Their wide operating temperature range, they are low and consistent cost. They can withstand very high vibration, and most important, they are self-powered. So they do not require a current or voltage source. Definitely, they have certain limitations too, means as compared to other temperature measuring devices. That is, first one is they are not as accurate as RTDs in certain set of temperature ranges. Second is thermocouples are susceptible to drift over time. But you know, we install them in thermowells, so we can easily remove and maintain it, basically recalibrate it. Then thermocouples, when badly insulated, are vulnerable to corrosion. Then next is thermocouple signals are not perfectly linear. So friends, this was all about thermocouples used in power plant industry for temperature measurement. Hope I am able to clear the concept well. Your valuable feedback is most welcomed. So please share your feedback in comment section. We'll meet again in our next video. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy, take care, bye.